It's the Linemakers on Sporting News.
NBA Finals Game 7 from Miami. Series all tied up at 3 apiece. The Heat are 6-point favorites, total down to 189.5. Welcome to the Linemakers on Sporting News. I'm Michael Roberts with Rick Herron. Rick, we saw the Heat finally win a game without covering in Game 6, one of the most fantastic playoff games you'll ever see. How does this come in now with the tired Spurs squad and a Heat team that kind of looked like they're in headlights at times in Game 6?
Yeah, Mike, it was a great game. I mean, 95 all overtime when Ray Allen hit the three with 5 seconds to go. I'm not so worried about fatigue because it's a Game 7. And you know, these guys played all year for a chance to win a championship in a Game 7 on both sides. I have to wonder a little bit about the Spurs' psyche, even though they're a veteran basketball team, that they had a championship. They were 5.2 seconds away from a championship when Allen hit the three. But I think they'll come back and play very, very well. You know, you can make a case for either side in Game 7, to be perfectly honest with you. The Spurs are 4-0 after a loss in the playoffs and won those four games by an average of 18.5 points a game. Flip it around the other way, a road team has lost the last five Game 7s in the finals. They're 3-14 overall in Game 7s in the finals. The last road team to win, believe it or not, the last road team to win a Game 7 in the finals was in 1978, was the Washington Bullets at Seattle. But they've only played five Game 7s in the finals in that 35 years.
Wow.
So, you know, I said you can, and you look at it from the Heat's point of view, they haven't won back-to-back games, consecutive games, since a five-game winning streak from May 8th to May 22nd.
Yeah, and that's hard to believe,
right?
Especially in the playoff. The Pacers struggled there, struggled against the Spurs, but they did come back. They showed a little heart, and in that spot there, Dwayne Wade, non-existent fourth quarter. You saw Chalmers step up. He made some big shots. Ray Allen stepped up when he had to. And then LeBron James himself put the team on his back without the headband. I don't know what happened, what the story was at that. But fourth quarter, he was a changed man. He was no longer afraid to take the shot, drive to the basket. Because at times, didn't it look like he didn't, it was a hot potato, he didn't want to touch the ball? Same with Wade and Bosch, for that matter.
But LeBron was a beast in the fourth quarter in overtime. You know, I mean, he was 3 out of 12. From the floor going into the fourth quarter. Ended up going 8 for 14 with 18 points in the fourth quarter and overtime. Ended up with 32, 10, and 11. Like you said, Chalmers had 20, Wade 14, Bosch 10 and 11, and the two huge blocks down the stretch. You look at it and you go into this game, and it's been a hard series to figure out. It's been a really good series. I don't think it's been a classic series because 4 of the 6 games were blowouts, but it was a classic Game 6. Spurs shot 43.5% from the floor. The Heat shot 46.9% and made 11 out of 19 threes. On the other side of the coin for San Antonio, Tony Parker was 6 out of 23 from the floor. Danny Green, who had broken the all-time record for threes in the finals with 25, was 1 for 7. Between them, 7 for 30 from the floor, and Manu Ginobili had 9 points and 8 turnovers.
Yeah,
so you can't expect that to happen in Game 7 out of those three guys either.
Now, I mentioned the fatigue because it did look like Tony Parker started to tire. He played a lot of minutes. Duncan, 25 points in the first half, only 5 between the second half and overtime. So it appeared with all the minutes that they logged in there that there was a little bit of fatigue, and there's a short turnaround. It's not even 48 hours since the last time they played. They're in the same city, but it is a short turnaround. I don't know. That doesn't bother you at all?
Yeah, the Heat looked a little worn out, too, at the end of the game, especially if you watched them in the press conference. It's a giant emotional swing and an emotional game and a physical game.
And,
you know, the fourth quarter and the overtime.
49 free throws.
Yeah, extremely physical. As you said, Duncan, no points and 3 rebounds in the fourth quarter and overtime combined,
wow,
even though he went for 30 and 17. So, from all the stuff we discussed, you could make a case for either side with the Heat laying 6. I got to think, for my money, that the value is in taking the points.
Expect another close game.
We've had 2 close games. Spurs won game 192-88, lose by 3 in overtime in game 6, the other 4 blowouts. I just think they're very equally matched basketball teams at this point, and I think that Parker and Danny Green and Ginobili are going to shoot it better in game 7. I think it's going to be a close game. I think the values have taken the points.
And the coaching adjustments have been great by both coaches,
both
actually. Spoelstra did some great maneuvering in game 6 by
small.
Sitting Wade, changing the lineup around a little bit, and then we've also seen some great things out of Popovich there. And you almost feel like Popovich in a game 7 situation where he's never lost an NBA Finals is the spot to go when the money's on the line.
I love Popovich, and you have to love his comments after the game. You asked him how he's going to prepare for Game 7 after losing Game 6 that way in overtime. He said, we're going to get on the bus, we're going to get off on the ramp, we're going to come in here, we're going to go on the floor, we're going to play. That's it. That was his comment. That's how we prepare for Game 7.
How about the total? 4 straight overs now in this series. A series probably could have had all 6 games go over the way some of the flow was. But Game 6 slowed down after a rapid-fire first quarter. And each possession, there seemed to be a sense of urgency with each possession, slowing it down a little bit. And the game only got over because it went into overtime. Any thoughts on the adjusted total down to 189.5 this time around?
Mike, I'm always going to lean to under in Game 7 just because I think both sides are going to be nervous early in the game. But I'm not going to play the total. I'm just taking the 6 with San Antonio.
Okay, now we got to, I guess, to win the series price, the money line on the game, plus 220 with the Spurs, minus 280 with the Heat. Would you like
It's a hedge spot. Yep. If you have the Heat, you take the you take the 220, 2.25, or you take the 6. It depends on what your action is and what your futures are.
So you like the Spurs in this game, taking the points.
Taking the points, not playing them on the money line.
All right, so if you got the Heat to win the series, maybe, or win the championship, maybe it's a hedge play, win both bets. You still have a shot there with the Spurs, get a repeat of game 6, and everybody cashes and is happy. Thanks for watching. See you next year.